At Meta's Connect this year, they released the Spatial SDK and Meta Spatial Editor, which allows Android developers to bring their 2D apps into Meta VR headsets. As this SDK is Kotlin-based, you can use mobile development languages, tools, and libraries that you're already familiar with to create an immersive experience. In this video, you'll learn to import the Meta Spatial SDK into an existing Android project and build a variation of your app for the Quest devices. In the next video, we'll see how to install the Meta Spatial Editor and use it along with Android Studio to build our application from scratch. Now, if you don't have an existing project, then don't worry. We'll be using a template that's developed by Meta. Now, if you have an existing Android app or a project that you'd like to bring inside VR, then you can follow along with me. However, I would highly recommend you to watch this tutorial till the end using the Meta template. And once you're familiar with the concepts, you can do the same for your application. Also, you can find all the code snippets, downloadable files, and the links that I will be referring to later on in this video in the description below. Alright, so with that out of the way, let's get started. As a prerequisite, you need to have downloaded and installed the latest version of Android Studio. I'm using the version 2024.1.2, and it has to be set up with the latest version of Android SDK with API level 34 and with all the other required build tools. Next, you'll need a MetaQuest headset with the developer mode enabled. Now, if you're not sure how that's done, then you can check out this video over here. Next, we can download the Meta Spatial SDK samples project and run it to make sure that it meets all the requirements. Once you have the sample project downloaded, you can navigate inside the Android Studio, open the project, select Meta Spatial SDK samples, scroll down till you find the starter sample and open that. Here, you'll notice a pop-up recommending you to upgrade the Gradle plugin version. Do not do it, it's a trap. It's gonna give you a lot of errors later on. So ignore it, at least for now. Next, connect your headset to the computer and it will automatically detect your device, which you can see over here. And this confirms that you have the developer mode enabled on your headset. And now, to validate your Android Studio project setup, all you need to do is click on the play button. Now, when you run it for the first time, it might take a couple of minutes. Once that's done, it will install this application on your headset where you see a VR environment. You can use your controllers to move and look around. You can even use the rain traction to interact with the canvas. Nothing happens right now. There's nothing wrong with it. That's how it is supposed to be. Now, if you're able to do all of these, it means that you have set up your project correctly. Now, you can close this project and download the Meta Spatial app template, which is nothing but a regular Android application that lets us play some videos. Open this in the Android Studio and wait for it to import. Once again, do not fall for this trap. Just ignore the Gradle update for now. Now, to show you the application, I've connected my Android device to the computer, as you can see here. And when I press play, it installs this app on my phone where I can scroll through a list of videos and play them. Perfect. Now, the next step is to create a build variant for the Quest devices. And to do that, you need to navigate inside apps and open build.gradle.kts file and paste these lines of code inside the Android block. Now, to manage the differences between the mobile phone version and the Quest version of our application, we need to create two new folders named as mobile and Quest inside SRC, which is inside app. In this template, the folders are already created, so you don't have to create them. However, if you're following along with your own project, then you'll have to do it. Next, navigate inside the main folder, copy the Android manifest file, paste it once inside the mobile folder, and then paste it once again inside the Quest folder. Then you can sync the project with Gradle by clicking on this button over here. Once that's done, we can navigate inside the main menu, builds, select build variant, and we want to set the active build variant as Quest debug. Now, as you can see here, the Quest directory is marked as the main one, and the Android manifest inside this will now be used for building. Now, if you switch the active debug variant back to mobile, then the Android manifest file inside the mobile will be used. Alright, now that we have a build variant created, we can finally work towards converting this 2D app into an immersive experience. And the first step towards that is to add the Meta Spatial SDK. For that, you'll have to open the builds.gradle.kts file, which is inside the apps folder, the same file that we edited a while back. In this file, right before the dependency, we can add this line of code. And inside the dependency, we can add these lines of code. And now, when we sync the project with Gradle, it's going to import these three packages into our project. I hope you know about Android's Activity class. If not, I will leave a link for this in the description. Now, the Meta Spatial SDK offers a subclass of this called as App System Activity. We can use this subclass to create a new activity to launch the immersive experience of our app. And for that, we need to create a new folder called Java inside the quest directory. And inside this, we need to create a new package called as com.meta.media.template. And in here, we need to create a new class called as immersive activity. Then copy paste this entire code from the reference link that's provided in the description below. Here you'll see that it's using the appSystem.activity as the subclass. And here you'll also find the boilerplate functions like register features, onScreenReady, and entity.create. Now this script has two references. First is the environment.glb and the second one is r.drawable.skydraw. Now you can download these assets once again from the reference link that we have provided and place the environment.glb inside the asset folder under the quest directory, and the SkyDome image can be placed under resolution drawable. Now since we are using the template, these folders are already created for us. If you are using your own project, then make sure to create the asset folder and place it inside that. Create a resolution folder, a drawable folder, and place the SkyDome inside that. Also, it's good to know that all the mesh assets that you have will always be stored inside the asset folder. Next, we need to update the Android manifest file to point to our new immersive activity class and add the necessary permissions or features for VR support. And to do that, you can delete the existing code and copy paste the reference that's provided. Now, if you compare this to the Android manifest inside the mobile folder, the first thing that you'll notice that it has a ton of required features or permission for VR support on Quest. Then if you scroll down and have a look at the main activity, you'll notice that the intent filter is removed so that it is no longer the launcher activity. Instead, the immersive activity has been added and that has been set as the launcher. Now when you try to build variants, Android will merge the Android manifest inside the Quest folder with the Android manifest inside the main folder, and this will lead to conflicts between the launcher activity. So to fix this, you'll have to open the Android manifest inside the main folder and delete the entire activity tag. Now to test if we can see the environment and the skybox that we added, you can connect your headset and press the play button. Here you should be able to see this environment and the skybox. Now moving on to the last step, which is adding panels. In the Meta Spatial SDK, panels serve as a container for your 2D content, which means that you can use this 2D surface, aka panels, to execute complete Android application. Now the SDK is compatible with various 2D Android frameworks, giving you the flexibility to choose a framework that suits you the best. But for this video, we'll be using classic XML. So the first step towards this would be to create an ID for the panel. And to do that, you need to create a new folder called values inside the rest directory. And inside the values, you can create a new value resource file called as IDs and paste this code inside the resources tag. Then inside the immersive activity file, you can import this package and then create a panel entity by adding these lines of code. Next, to register this ID and link it to our activity, first we need to import this package. And then after the onScreenReady function, we can use the registerPanel function to link the activity. And that's about it. This time when you run the application, you'll be able to see your app running inside VR, which is super cool, right? If you want to build a completely new immersive app using Android Studio and Meta Spatial Editor, then do let us know in the comments below. If there are enough number of people who want to see this tutorial, then we'll definitely make one and link it somewhere on this page. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.